Hello friends, welcome to our geography videos. In this geography videos, we are seeing Ganga Basin and all other aspects of it. Already we have made two videos for this Ganga River and its basins. I hope you should have watched both of these previous videos. Now this is the part 3 of Ganga Basin videos. Let us go into this videos now. In this third part of the video, we will be sailing along the River Ganga from Varanasi. Now let us try to see some aspects about Varanasi. I hope you all know Varanasi is one of the oldest of the cities in India and it has been referred as Kasi or Banaras. It is one of the seven holiest or the sacred cities in India. According to legend, Varanasi was founded by Lord Shiva himself. And the Bhakti saint Adi Shankara established the worship of Shiva here in Varanasi. Tulasidas, a famous poet, wrote Ramacharitmanas in Varanasi. Tulasidas lived around 1500 AD. Also, the Bhakti saint Kabir and Ravidas, they both were born in Varanasi. There is a place very close to Varanasi which is called Sarnath. I hope you should know that Buddha, after attaining enlightenment from a place which is called Bodh Gaya, he walked all the way from Bodh Gaya to Sarnath and he delivered his first sermon in a place Sarnath, and in Sarnath he delivered the speech in a deer park, and the name of the first sermon happens to be Dharma Chakra Pravartana, or turning the wheel of Dharma. And in Sarnath a stupa had been established by Ashoka to commemorate Buddha's sermon. Varanasi also is a residence of many important ancient Indian scholars. Susruta, the great surgeon of ancient India, lived here. Susruta is said to be the first surgeon who lived in India, and he has compiled a book which is called Susruta Samhita. Also in Varanasi, we have Diesel Locomotive Works Unit, which is under Bharat Heavy Electricals. Also, this is located here. The present Prime Minister Narendra Modi got elected from Varanasi in the year 2014 Lok Sabha elections. Varanasi is also known for a form of Hindustani classical music emerged here. The name of this happens to be Banaras Gharana. And Ustad Bismillah Khan, who was a Chennai player, also was born and lived in Varanasi. Anni Besant founded her Central Hindu College here. This Central Hindu College later came to be called as Banaras Hindu University. Varanasi also is known for the famous Jantar Mantar. I should have spoken about this Jantar Mantar in the previous slides. And Jantar Mantar is an astronomical observatory and sundial. And this is constructed by Raja Jai Singh in the year 1739. Raja Jai Singh constructed 5 Jantar Mantars in different parts in India. And this include Jantar Mantar at Ujjaini, Delhi, Mathura, Jaipur and Varanasi. And among the 5 Jantar Mantars, one at Jaipur is the biggest of all. And the Jaipur Jantar Mantar had been given a UNESCO World Heritage Site status. The important temples in Varanasi is Kasi Vishwanatha Temple. This temple is one of the 12 Jyotirlinga Shiva temples. Durga Mandir is another important temple, and Parsanatha Jain temple is also famous in Varanasi. Varanasi is also known for ghats. Ghats are cremation grounds, and the important ghats include Manikarnika Ghat, Panchganga Ghat, Harishchandra Ghat, etc. Varanasi also has many GA tags to its credit. The famous being Banarasi Sari is very important. This Banarasi sari is made of finely woven silk. It is known for their gold, silver, brocade or zari. Because of these engravings, they are relatively heavy. And for information, for making one sari, sometimes it takes 6 months to complete totally. Varanasi is also known for Banaras Gulabi Minakari craft. This craft uses pink enameling and received a GA tag in 2015. Banaras is also known for Banaras Metal Repose craft. This technique is an age-old technique. From the times, this technique had been preserved by a community which is called Kasira community. And this technique could be seen being used in temples like Golden Temple of Amritsar, Kashi Vishwanatha Temple and Jagannath Temple Puri. Varanasi also has got another GA tag which is for Varanasi Wooden Lacquer Ware and Toys. This is known for their bright, colorful lacquered toys. Another GA tag in Varanasi happens to be Varanasi glass beads. It is a pure handicraft and the technique used in Varanasi is called lamp winding technique. Next we will move to a city which is called Patna. Patna has been referred in ancient India as Pataliputra. It is one of the oldest and continuously inhabited cities in the world. And Patna had served as one of the important capitals of almost all the dynasties in ancient India. These dynasties include Haryanka dynasty, Nanda dynasty, Mauryas, Shungas, Guptas and Pala empires. And Patna had been a home to many important scholars in ancient India. They include Paninin, who authored a book which is called Astadhyaya, which happens to be the earliest grammar work. And we have an astronomer who is called Aryabhatta, who has authored Aryabhattiyam. He also resided in Patna. Chanakya, one of the very important ministers during the time of Mauryas, also lived in Patna, and he authored a book which is called Arthashastra. And Kalidasa wrote Sakuntalam. Kalidasa is one of the greatest poets in India, who also resided in Patna. Also, we have another important author who is called Vatsyayana, who had authored a book which is called Kamasutra, who resided in Patna. Patna is the place where River Son, Gandak, Punpun, they merge with Ganga. Patna is the birthplace of the 10th Sikh Guru, Guru Gobind Singh. There are many important leaders who are associated with Patna. Swami Sajananda Saraswati, a peasant leader, is also associated with Patna. And we have the first president of India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who was born and who resided in Patna. And we have Jayaprakash Narayanan, who had been fondly referred as Lok Nayak. He also hails from Patna. The native dialect in Patna is Magadhi, or it is called as Mahahi, named after Magadha. Other widely spoken dialects in Patna include Bhojpuri, Mithali, Bengali, Urdu and Oriya. Mahatma Gandhi Setu, which is built here in Patna across the river Ganga, is one of the longest river bridges in India. The length of the river bridge is approximately 5.6 kilometers. Magadha region also has many GA tags to its credit. Madhubani paintings is one such, and Mahahi Pan is another important GA indicator which has been given in Magadha, and also Bagalpur silks. The other GA tags include applique or contour works, Sujani embroidery works and Sikki grass work. This Sikki grass work, it is made from a special grass which is found in Magadhi region. Next we will move to a city which is called Murshidabad. Murshidabad is a place where we have a Faraka barrage. This barrage is built across Ganga in the year 1975. The purpose for the construction of the barrage are many. First, to divert water from Ganga to this Hooghly River, so that the sediments which are deposited in this Hooghly River is removed, because this sediment has to be removed for the berthing of the ships. Also, to restore navigability, this water is being used. We have come to the end of part 3 of the 4-part series of the Ganga River Basin. Please keep in touch for the 4th part of the video. Thank you.